about to get started here with the Montreal Nukes Kids on the Block versus Carolina All-Stars here at the WTBA East Region Tournament.
East Region Playoffs.
Oh, you almost nailed it. Almost nailed it. That's right. In the background, you'll be probably hearing some other announcers blabbing, and that would be Plastic Patrick from Montreal and Rev Almighty, if you're curious, who's doing the in-house call.
And he's wearing a shirt today.
Mr. Al?
Yes.
Mr. Mighty? Yes.
He needs to show off the guns.
So we're just finishing up equipment checks here, and then we'll be underway. So we're getting started about 15 minutes late, so that might affect the rest of the schedule for the day. But regardless of when they begin, the next bout that will be coming up after this, I'm nicknaming it Lobster Palooza, and that will be Boston versus Maine. So both states love lobster. Maine a little bit more famous for their lobster. Boston, maybe they eat more there, actually. And that's going to be exciting. That scheduled start time for that one is noon time, although might get started a little late. We shall see. And just want to let you guys know, in case you're curious, on the unofficial Derby News Network rankings, very unofficial, Montreal is ranked number 14 nationally, or in the WFTDA, and Carolina is ranked number 23. Again, those are just unofficial power rankings. All right. And we actually, it looks like we have skaters taking the track. We are going to get day two of the Nightmare on 95, the East Region Playoffs, started for you guys.
Looks like Smack Daddy up on the pivot line with number 8, Jess Bandit for Montreal.
So I see JoJo Gadget taking up the rear there for Carolina. And all of our skaters are in their start positions. Looks like we are going to be underway. And the first whistle has blown, and we are started. In case you are new to roller derby, everybody, we have two groups of skaters that are on the track. The front group of skaters is called the Pack, made up of a bunch of blockers from each team. And then those two skaters who are off with the stars on their helmets are the Jammers. And that's Holly Wanacracky, number 999. There for Carolina.
Georgia W. Tush jamming for Montreal.
That's right. And Holly Wanacracky has earned lead jammer status, meaning she can call off the jam at any time if she so pleases, as long as she is not in the penalty box.
Georgia W. Tush getting tangled up on the front line for Carolina.
And Holly Wanacracky here entering the back of the pack, and she'll be scoring points on this scoring pass and all other passes during this jam. Every time she passes a Montreal blocker legally, she is getting 1 point on the board. Oh, a big swing there by Lil Mama on Holly Wanacracky at the back, but Holly Wanacracky is still up. She does not have to call off the jam yet. She's got a little bit of space, although coming up on her heels is a Montreal jammer, and she called off the jam.
Smack Daddy with a great hit to the inside on that last whistle there for Montreal. Georgia W. Tush looking a little frustrated as she came off the track.
And Carolina there, the first to strike, 3-0 on the board here. And we had a penalty-free first jam, at least a major penalty-free first jam. They are major penalties, which majorly impact play, and minor penalties, and you have to earn 4 of those to get a trip to the penalty box.
Cheese grater out for pivot for Montreal with Iron Wench jamming. She goes to the outside and back to the inside.
That's right, and there goes JoJo Gadget, the jammer for Carolina. She's trying to push her way through the Montreal blockers at the front, who set up a nice little 2 or 3 person wall there. Iron Wench squeezing through, almost. Oh. Not quite. Looked like she was about to emerge. Iron Wench electing to play defense on the first pass here. Looked like she had a way to get out of the pack, but she elected to turn around. Actually, maybe paying the price there a little bit as JoJo Gadget emerged first. 2 straight lead jammers for Carolina. you see actually Holly Wanacracki there was trying to chase out Iron Wench to try to get her back into the pack, but just had to let her go. She was too far out. You cannot engage more than 20 feet outside of the pack.
Carolina setting up at the front of the pack.
And right now, we've got JoJo Gadget as your lead jammer, even though she's well behind, and she's just going to let Iron Wench burn off a little, burn off a few calories from last night's after party.
Oh yeah.
And then call it off before any damage is done.
Looks like Carolina's going to start off with their pivot in the box.
That's right. A pivot is the blocker who has the stripe on their panty.
Montreal looks like they're going to start off with a no-pack situation, releasing the jammer right off the line. Thrashley having some trouble getting through the head of the pack as there's a green wall set up.
All right, we've got our first lead jammer of the night for Montreal's Mange-moi el cou, number 1X. All right. And Thrashley is out as well. She's not your lead jammer here, so a chance for Montreal to get on the scoreboard. Mange-moi el cou entering the pack. She's got a wall of three at the front. They gotta let her go. There was a no-pack situation there. And 4 points are picked up. Montreal.
Montreal learning is teaming up a little bit. They're working the pack, and like you said, the pack situation as they try to gang up in the back. And now they're Carolina opts for the destruction of the pack play, no pack play at the beginning.
That's right. As long as you start with no pack, it is not a considered an official destructing the pack call. And this will allow the jam to start immediately after the first whistle. Normally they have to wait until everybody passes the blocker line. All right, and Holly Wanacracki, the jammer for Carolina here. Oh, she's a little inside, outside move there.
Georgia W. Tush gets on through the inside line.
And that's right, Carolina, once again, though, is your lead jammer here. Status, and so they will be eligible to score points first as Holly Wanacracki entering the back of the pack, and she slips on through on her knees. Let's see what any points she was awarded. 0 points were awarded there for either team. 0-0 jam, so Montreal retains a commanding 4-3 lead.
It's a wake-up call this morning.
That's right, and this broadcast brought to you by Elemental Technologies. Elemental Technologies is the world's most powerful video processing solutions. Elemental Technologies, thank you for sponsoring the WFTDA East Region Playoffs and all the playoffs of the WFTDA. We've got a quick lead. Jammer status earned by number 299, Ginger Clobbers from Carolina. Oh, so she is not through. She's not your lead jammer. You have to get through there legally.
Number 516 for Montreal, Iron Wench, just made through and got through, and she gets lead jam and calls it off right away.
That's right. Ginger Clobbers was not your lead jammer due to a minor low block there. And we thank our announcer ref here, Patricide, for filling us in on all those little things that we don't pick up on.
Cheese grater pivot out there for Montreal with number 202, Nameless Horror.
That's right. Some physical stuff going on in there. Smack Daddy showing a little love, if you want to call it that, to some of the Carolina blockers. There's some Montreal antics going on in the pack. There's Smack Daddy once again skating around, and we've had our first whistle.
Yeah.
But the second jam whistle will not go until there's no pack situation like we just had there, or they pass the line.
T. Lou trying to get out by the pack on the outside line, gets sucked back in. She's got one more Carolina blocker to get past.
And she does. Nice work by T. Lou there, just sneaking by number 224 there.
Carolina That's jammer makes slip. It through. Probably want to crack you, number 999.
And we've got a really spread out pack right here. They're reformed here, and they're all together. At the front is T. Lou. Will be engaging first with
Misanthrope.
Misanthrope, the mordant. All right. Looks like we actually had a point picked up by Carolina there. And no points picked up in Montreal. So tie a game. Have a drink.
Little Irish
Bloody Mary drink, I'm assuming.
Or Irish coffee.
Yeah. Or one of those morning beverages.
Or beer.
That's right.
Whatever. Hydrate.
Or water.
Or vitamin water, one of our sponsors here today. Vitamin water, thank you for donating hydration to our skaters and officials.
All right, we are underway. Georgia W. Tush got two walkers to beat at the front here, and she sneaks around them, and she's the lead jammer for Montreal. Celia Fate here, the jammer for Carolina, trying to get through the front of the pack. And they've got to let her go. Jess Bandit had to let her go there. She's just a little bit too far out of play. Georgia W. Tush here entering on her scoring pass. And sneaking up on the back of the pack there was Celia Fate. Georgia W. Tush calling off the jam. Looked like just at the right time. Able to pick up 3 points. All right, here. We're ready for our next jam here. Montreal with a 3-point lead going in. And is that Iron Wench over there? That's the jammer. We are at the far side. We are on turn one here, folks. So sometimes it takes an extra second to figure out who those jammers
yes.
are.
Yes, it's 516.
All right, that's Iron Wench. She's going against JoJo Gadget here, the jammer for Carolina, who is doing a lot of hard work at the front of the pack. They're able to sneak out. Not your lead jammer, though. Do a minor track cut. And Iron Wench, the lead jammer, calls it off. So that's the second time so far we've seen Carolina get out first, but not do it legally. And Montreal get out just in time, get lead jammer at the very last second and call off the jam before any damage was done.
I love watching Iron Wench skate. She looks like one of those speed skaters when she comes around the corner. Sometimes she's going so fast, she sweeps the corner, the apex with her hand.
Yes. She definitely has an unusual form, one that you wouldn't see amongst most skaters.
I think it's that Canadian hockey background.
All right, Carolina's taking a knee there to start that jam right away. Well, I'm not sure why they did not have a pack advantage, so they were electing to get it started, though, early. And Majmois El Cool now, the jammer for Montreal, stuck in the very back, but we've got elite jammer status for Carolina.
DVS and Jesse King for Carolina, keeping Montreal's jammer in check in the back.
That's right. And here's Aris Discordia already on her first scoring pass here, entering the pack, picking up points for Carolina. All right, looks like we had a fourth minor picked up there by Jesse King. Said, oh, wait a second, we've got actually Majmois El Cool being sent to the penalty box for a major forearm here. So we're going to have a power jam for Carolina. Maybe a little bit of a mistake there calling off the jam. Maybe not realizing they had the power jam here. They were already on their scoring passes. Could be a bit of a costly mistake.
Yeah, I think it looked like Air Discordia was about to step off the track, and I think it confused some of their players and didn't realize that it was called on a Montreal player.
That's right. So we actually have a 4-4 pack here for this power jam for Carolina. So again, they're now going to have to earn lead jammer status in order to get back on those scoring passes. This Holly Wanakrakia is the jammer here for Carolina. Counting on her to put up some points here to get a lead here for Carolina. Oh, and we've got a goat caught at the back. That's when, see, Carolina here has slowed down a Montreal blocker, and that's allowing Holly Wanakrakia to push out the Montreal blockers and force them to be out of play. And Lil Mama now stuck at the back. We've got an incredibly slow pack. This is going to allow Holly Wanakrakia to make a scoring pass in less than 10 seconds there. And that was a full 5-point grand slam.
Lil Mama finally working her way out of that trap. To join her teammates at the front of the pack.
Oh, Holly Wanakrakia was tossed into the back there. Looks like she picked up a minor back block, not a major back block. She didn't knock the player down. We've got out of play being called on number 8 there. That's Jess Bandit. So Holly Wanakrakia, another 5-point grand slam. Oh, nice move. A little inside-outside move getting around Jess Bandit there. Holly WannaCry, five more points for Carolina. That would be three full scoring passes here.
Iron Winch gets back on the track, and she finally makes it through. She was tied up there by Carolina.
That's right, but Holly WannaCry here on her fourth scoring pass here. Got one more to beat at the front. Let's see if she was able to pick them off. She calls off the jam. Four more points. So that was a 19-0 jam for Carolina. Suddenly we've got a 19-point lead. I'm going to tell you about another one of the sponsors of the WFTDA Championships. That would be Adam Wheels. Adam Wheels is the official wheel of the WFTDA. So, folks, if you're keep track at home, we actually had a tie bout just a second ago, and all of a sudden it looks like Carolina. If you're just joining us, you're like, Carolina's been dominating. Absolutely not. They had one very successful 19-0 power jam just now for Holly WannaCry.
Georgia W. Tush jamming for Montreal gets lead jam. Deviled Legs getting tied up in the back of the pack as she gets a strong hit on turn three.
She
makes it past Smack Daddy.
That's right. She does. She's not your lead jammer, though. Of course, she is behind. Georgia W. Tush sneaks on out for a quick classic 4-0 jam for Montreal. Like we said, Carolina's not necessarily dominating, so Montreal just kind of going to inch their way back into this thing.
None of these teams are going to play like also-rans this morning.
All right, we've got a timeout called by the Montreal bench. We'll take this opportunity to tell you about some more of our sponsors. Rydell Skates, proud partner and the official skate of the WFTDA. That's Rydell Skates.
Also, Iron Doll. Iron Doll clothing, one of the kind uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee.
All right, we've got a big huddle going out in the middle of the track there. And we've got, just looking around at the crowd right now, we've got a crowd of a few hundred people here right now enjoying the first bout of the day. And again, the next bout coming up after this will be Boston taking on Maine.
Lobster Palooza.
That's right. And the winner of that bout will play against London. The winner of this bout, Carolina versus Montreal, will play against Dutchland. And that will be tonight at 6 p.m. they will be playing.
They're going to have to rename the DuBurns Arena the Burns Center because there's a lot of hot derby action.
Yes, they are.
Yes. Third degree burns.
And you know what? This evening, like starting this afternoon, actually, at 2 p.m., we've got some unbelievably exciting semifinals going on here. Gotham Girls, are going to be taking on Steel Hurtin' from Steel City from Pittsburgh there. That'll be taking place at 2 p.m. And then immediately after that, Charm City will be taking on the Philadelphia Liberty Bells at 4 p.m. in the other semifinal.
Steel Hurtin' looking great from yesterday up against Gotham. That's going to be great. And also, we'd like to thank Charm City Roller Girls for hosting the event. They put together a great production here in Baltimore. Actually got to play hooky last night and went to see an Orioles game.
Really? How was it? Who won?
Baltimore. Yay.
What?
Baltimore beat the Angels. I know that.
That's
you know,
incredible.
Yeah. It's a couple other announcers playing hooky and paying for it this morning.
Very nice. Yeah, Baltimore has some really beautiful parts, and Camden Yards is definitely one of them.
Oh, yeah.
So we're definitely enjoying our time down here. In case you're wondering, we've got beautiful weather here this weekend for the WFTDA East Region Playoffs. We're assuming that's why the beautiful weather is here, because all these beautiful ladies and beautiful, some beautiful gentlemen, not as many as the ladies.
They could be more beautiful if they use Dr. Hauschka. Lose the bruise with Dr. Hauschka's Arnica products. Ouchade for your bruises.
Very nice. So a timeout from Montreal has turned into a lengthy one at that. We're just about ready to get underway. We have a little figuring out going on with penalties here. We'll give you an update in a moment.
There's
All right, so we've been informed by Patricide, our announcer ref here, that there was a little bit of a discrepancy as to the scoring there from Montreal. They were asking for an official review, and there is no change being made. So everything stands as it is, as 26-11, and our timeout is finally just about over. And there we go. We're going to be back underway. Hope you guys enjoyed that timeout.
Brought to you by Neon Green, the official uniform color of Montreal.
I didn't know they were a sponsor.
If you close your eyes, you can still see the Montreal players.
Is Neon Green putting up big money for that call out there? I hope so.
Green Monsters.
If I recall correctly, there was a whistle blown. And yes, now we have some blockers moving. We have a micro pack, just 2-2. Looks like Carolina happy to run off some time there to get some of their blockers out of the penalty box. An iron way. Oh, look at that. Thrashley jumping the apex there as your lead jammer. As long as your skates do not touch the ground in between, you can fly through the air. Do whatever you want. Iron Wench is out as well, but she is about a half a lap behind, and a quick pass there for Thrashley. 4 points for Carolina.
Carolina dominating the entire width of the track, would not let the Montreal jammer through. Usually you see a team like either favoring the inside lane or the outside lane, but they had it completely covered and shut it down in Montreal.
That's right, they did. And once again, Carolina electing to take a knee here with a slight pack advantage. Pretty much the strategy nowadays is anytime you have a pack advantage at all, you take a knee, you stretch out that jam, don't let the other team get their blockers back on the track. Oh, but didn't make a difference right there, as Dilou is through as your lead jammer for Montreal. Au is her number. And we've got about a half lap lead. Tilu's got about a half lap lead entering here. And right now we've got all Montreal, though, at the back of the pack. Oh, the Tilu with a lot of speed. Going right through, calling off the jam for 4 points. So far, we've seen a lot of perfectly timed call offs here. It looks like Tilu just sensed that she had enough time to get all four of those points and then call it off.
Yeah,
just before.
Number 23, Ares Discordia, had so much speed coming around the track. It's like, but you're right, that timing. She could have gotten a couple points. I had to check with the ref, but she was just so fast. She timed it perfectly that she didn't get any points.
That's right, and they are eligible to score points until the fourth whistle has blown. So a lot of times you'll see a skater sneak in there and get a point at the last second. We've got a 3-3 pack right now. One blocker from both teams in the penalty box. Georgia W. Tush, the jammer for Montreal. Nice block out of bounds on her, and she had to come back. She's stuck at the back here.
Deviled legs going inside, outside, and finally passing on the inside between turns 3 and 4.
That's right, Georgia W. Tush about one length of a lap lead on Georgia W. Tush. A straightaway lead, and here she comes. Deviled legs into the back. She's a lot of contact there. Looks like she might have picked up a minor back block. And Georgia W. Tush, though, is snuck into the back and actually passed Deviled Legs. So Deviled Legs really has no choice here but to try and get her 4 points and then call off the jam.
Number 289, Cheese Grater, working over Deviled Legs on the inside and outside line. She's all over her.
That's right, Montreal, just a tough four-person wall. Let's see what Deviled Legs is able to pick up. She was able to pick up 3 points, so it was just a minus one there for Carolina. But nonetheless, when you have lead jammer and you're the first one back into the pack, you don't want to come out losing a point. There might actually be, you know, if I think about it now, there's actually two kind of costly call-offs there. Carolina in that power jam earlier called one off, although they ended up with a 19-0 jam the next time around. So it's tough to say that was really a costly call-off. All right, we are back. Hey, guess what? Carolina's taking a knee again.
Oh, Carolina.
Oh, jeez. Don't like to skate. What a bunch of slackers.
Except for probably want to crack it.
She's That's right.
Trying to crack open the door on Montreal in the front of the line. Ray Volver's up there.
That's right. She took a big hit on Ginger Clobbers, who just bounced right off of Ray Volver and is now through as your lead jammer. But guess what? Iron Wench is about a half a lap behind her, or half a quarter lap behind her, actually.
So Smack Daddy and Georgia W. Tush, or I'm sorry, Jess Bandit lining up at the front, and they try to get Ginger Clobbers.
Looks like it was a 2-2 jam there. Yep. Looks like a Carolina had a blocker who fell down and was easily engaged by Iron Wench at the back.
A lot of action happening up at the front of the packs in most of these jams.
Yeah, definitely. And just in case you guys don't know, you might wonder, well, both of those jammers only passed one blocker. Well, that's all they had to pass in order to get 2 points. They passed the one blocker on the track, and they immediately picked up the point for the blocker in the penalty box as well. Those are unofficially called ghost points. Montreal electing to take a knee here to get things started right away.
That's Georgia W. Tush, number 40 for Montreal with lead jam.
That's right. So Montreal had a 3-2 pack advantage here. Oh, we've got a big pile up at the back of the pack here. Georgia W. Tush about to get her lap point here for passing Thrashley, and she gets all five there. It's a 5-point grand slam.
Thrashley finally gets through.
We've got a micro pack now, just two blockers from both teams.
We got Jesse King up against 2x4 No Holds Barred on Montreal, going back and forth in the pack.
Oh. Georgia W. Tush called it off. Looks like she was able to pick up. Carolina able to pick up 2 points there? Is that right?
Yeah.
Looks like we might have actually had 2 points picked up by Carolina on that pass. None by Georgia W. Tush, so she was blocked to the outside, called it off. But again, before that fourth whistle, Thrashley had passed at least one blocker from Montreal. All right, so both teams taking that knee down strategy seriously today. Although it is a 3-3 pack right now. Holly Wanakrakia meeting that Montreal wall at the front.
It's like an
iron wench just sort of like nudging her way through everybody, but not picking up penalties. But she's not. Oh, she did pick up the penalty. She had a minor block in the back there, so hence nudging her way through. So Holly Wanakrakia may still be eligible for lead jammer here. We'll see it when she gets out. But Iron Wench here is already getting into the back of the pack on her scoring pass. And here she goes. She's not your lead jammer, but Iron Wench is through for full. 4 points, not quite 5 points.
Montreal outnumbered on the track there, but their defense is doing excellent work out there, particularly number 454 chasing Amy.
That's right, they finally had to let Holly Wanakrakia go, but the time was called in the jam. 2 more points picked up by Iron Wench there, so a 6-0 jam for Montreal despite not getting lead jammer. And we've got a timeout followed by Carolina.
Five Strides Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop of Bonnie Thunders, Deranged, Psycho Babble, and Susie Hot Rod, and Teflon Donna. Five Strides Skate Shop.
Yeah, that's right. Be sure to check them out. That is some elite company. If you shop there, you may be as good as some of those skaters. Not likely, but you never know. Also, WFTDA East Region Playoffs and all of the playoffs are brought to you by Derby Supply. Derby Supply, check them out. They have the best customer service in the period. No semicolons, no commas, no colons, period.
No parentheses.
No parentheses. All right. That was a short timeout. Actually, not a short timeout. That is how long timeouts are supposed to take. These timeouts take about one minute. And we're going to be back underway. So we'll be starting with a 4-3 pack advantage for Montreal, for Carolina, pardon me. And that's Devious, that's right, the pivot there. What's she doing? She's a pivot. She's touching the pivot line. That's what they do. That forces everybody to line up behind her. All right, Holly Wanakrakia here going up against Cheese Grater at the front of the pack and Nameless Horror. And she is able to sneak on through as your lead jammer, so Montreal unable to hold the double block there together.
T. Lou caught around the outside corner there.
Holly Wanakrakia already on her scoring pass here. We haven't even done a full lap of the pack yet. And we did have a pack there, but Holly Wanakrakia is finally out as the pack was spread out enough that there was not a pack.
202 Nameless Horror calling her teammates back.
Oh, we've got equipment on the track.
Me too.
Someone's mouth guard. It was picked up by Miss Anthrop de Mordant there, and she tossed the mouth guard aside, and we've got a 5-point pass there for Holly Wanakrakia.
T. Lou making her way on the outside line, ran into JoJo Gadget, number 313. JoJo Gadget pushing her across the track.
Wow, there was a backwards block there. I mean, she was skating in the right direction and facing T. Lou. Looked like that was Jesse King. Oh, who comes out of nowhere and lays into T. Lou. That's number 110 for Carolina with some big hits. First a backwards block, then it's a huge takeout.
Smack Daddy giving it right back to Carolina. We're stalled out on turn three.
Yes, we are. But Holly Wanakrakia is on her scoring pass. T. Lou is on her first pass here. So both jammers very frustrated with the situation here. And a fourth minor was picked up by T. Lou. Oh, both of our jammers called off to the penalty box at the exact same time. So they're both going to come out at just about the exact same time, but time has run off, so made absolutely no difference in the result of that jam. Very unusual that you see jammer penalties making zero difference in a jam, but I don't think I've ever seen that before. Two jammers called off the exact same time.
It was practically an empty net situation with the with the Carolina jammer turning into a blocker instead of a scorer.
That's right. One thing that they are good at Charm City here, and you won't know this because you're at home, but man, is it chilly in here. I'm sure the skaters absolutely love it, though. Skaters nice and cool. Talking to some Boston skaters after the bout. Looks like we've got an official timeout going on right now. Talked to some Boston skaters after their bout against Charm City last night, and they were concerned because they weren't really sweating.
I was talking
to Lois Carmen Dominic. She was like, I'm not even sweating. And she was really concerned that she hadn't worked hard enough, but her other teammates informed her that it was just chilly in here.
So. Very chilly. Well, we should start looking into selling derby blankets.
Yes, we should.
Blankets with hoods.
All right, and during this official timeout, we'll tell you about another sponsor for the WFTDA. That is Spenlin Media. Spenlin Media, you need it, we make it. Apparel, websites, and they make the Rules app for your Smarty Pants phone that you have.
You can just go download the app. Mm-hmm. It's got all your rules, so if you're sitting there watching, just bring it up on your phone. Because you're on your phone all the time anyway, you might as well know the rules.
That's right, and that's Spenlin, in case you're wondering on the spelling. That's S-P-E-N-L-E-N Media. Check them out.
And the flavor, if you could taste Derby, it would taste like vanilla. Vanilla skates. Let Vanilla Derby take you to success with their brand new top leather Renegade and straight jacket boots. Vanilla skates. America.
All right. So looks like we are back. And yeah, the skaters would like a little bit of noise from the crowd here. But hey, it is the 10, 11 o'clock hour here.
If you're watching at home, clap your hands. Louder.
Send them texts or something. Let them know you're listening. They'll check it at halftime, I'm sure. All right, so we are just about ready to get underway. And you know what? One of my favorite sponsors, Union Vacations, they're going to be providing the 2011 WFTDA MVP with a one-week getaway to Mexico. I think that's so awesome.
Yeah.
Union Vacations.
And they have roller derby in Mexico.
Yes, they do. Roller derby's everywhere.
World Cup coming up. Oh, what do I have up here? Birthday cake formation.
Yes, it is a birthday cake formation.
I stole that from Suzanne Wins.
All right. It's like Georgia W. Tush there trying to get her way around as the get lead jammer here around Jesse King. Jesse King's got to let her go. And we've got a quick Montreal lead jammer here.
JoJo Gadget is jamming for Carolina. She tries to get the blast on the inside, outside the inside, but she's got two Montreal blockers she has to get past. Still is in. And she gets by, finally.
Making sure she takes out a skater on the way.
Why not?
Yeah, sure. Whoa, Jesse King and Smack Daddy getting mixed up there. And Georgia W. Tush sneaking through in her first scoring pass for 4 points. Electing not to call off the jam, though. So we've got JoJo Gadget in here in her scoring pass as well. So it looks like Georgia W. Tush is going to try to get the differential on points here on the second scoring pass, not the first. 4 points were also picked up for Carolina.
Carolina playing two players down as two players are sitting in the penalty box right now.
Wow, that's some great one-on-one blocking at the back there by 131 Devious, showing you why she is a captain of Carolina. She, you can thank her completely for having essentially a 0-0 jam there. It was technically 4-4, but no differential right there. See, Montreal, Georgia W. Tush, really, she's thinking all right, JoJo Gadget's pretty close to me right now. I'm going to go for it on the second scoring pass. And she entered with about a half a lap lead, but just devious, just held her by herself. I mean, that's unbelievable one-on-one blocking. And our next jam is off, and that would be the
Iron Wench.
Getting through as your lead jammer quickly. Slight pack advantage here for Montreal, 3-2.
Looks like Celia Fate.
That's right.
Jamming for Carolina, number 0-0.
Nice offensive blocking there for Montreal, and calling off the jam for 4 quick points. That was a nice offensive block by Cheese Grater, number 289, clearing the way for the Iron Wench. You know, that's actually what they were looking for on the last bout, in the last jam. So they got it that time.
Iron Wench showing some great pack awareness again, showing the outfit, their timing.
All right. We are going to be starting this jam with, it looks like, a 3-2 pack advantage from Montreal. And very heads up coaching here, telling their teammates to take a knee.
It looks like Lil Mama out there jamming. Yes, it is. Lil Mama getting by on the outside. Lead jam for Montreal.
Wow, Lil Mama got up on her toe stops around turn 1 and 2 there and just ran around the Carolina blockers, getting lead jammer status. And Holly Wanacracka still in on her first pass. Smack Daddy with a nice hit, slowing down Holly Wanacracka, although Holly Wanacracka able to escape. And Lil Mama is here approaching the front of the pack, and she is through on her scoring pass. Almost through. Wow, re-engaged. Was able to pick up 4 points. She called off the jam. She got her points. No need to push for anything else.
Lil Mama, one of those passionate players you love seeing. She's out there.
That's
very
right.
Emotive.
That's right. So Montreal has been slowly creeping back into this. I think the largest lead for Carolina was about 19 points at one point, and now it is a 10-point lead for Carolina. So obviously both teams, neither team really establishing a commanding lead in this game. As Pelvis Costello loves to say, it's anybody's game right now. It really is. Is that my saying, Pelvis? Okay.
Ginger Clobber got knocked down on the inside on turn 1.
Georgia W. Tush is through as your lead jammer, but Ginger Clobber is through as well with about maybe a 10-20 foot lead here. This is going to be a race to the back of the pack. Miss Anthrop the Mordant trying to clear the way for her blockers, and looks like 4 points picked up for Montreal, 2 for Carolina. So inching a little bit closer, 56-48, 8-point lead.
That's a lot of praise on the line.
Nameless whore giving a high five to Georgia W. Tush there on the bench. Seems like the higher the score gets, you know, I think this is the temperature, 48 or 56.
It's approximately somewhere between 48 and 56 degrees in here. That is correct. I'm sure Patricide would agree. And we've got Iron Wench as your lead jammer again for Montreal. But holy moly, Holly Wanacracka turning on the jets. We have got an awesome jammer on jammer race going on right here. We are watching it. You guys are watching the pack on your screens. But here comes Iron Wench into the pack. Holly Wanacracka as well. Holly Wanacracka able to pick up 2. Iron Wench, no points there. Holly Wanacracka psyched about that result for Carolina. Woo! I just love that. Those are 2 really high caliber jammers right there, just going at it, getting out of the pack just about the same time. That was some exciting stuff.
It was almost a throwback jam. Any of those faster paced games that seems to have slowed down over the past year and a half, but that was a nice speed game there.
Sure was. And right now, if I count correctly, I see 1 Carolina blocker on the track right now, and 1 coming out of the penalty box.
And it's a Lil Mama, a lead jam for Montreal, getting past JoJo Gadget,
that's
number
right.
313 for Carolina, who's now blocking No Holds Barred in the back of the pack.
That's right. You see Carolina mixing up, sometimes having their jammers jam, sometimes having their jammers block. Some teams have exclusive jammers, who are exclusively jammers, and some do both. Oh, Lil Mama getting through there for 4-0 jam for Montreal. Now within 6 points. So again, they inching closer. Oh, geez. How did that happen? It's the end of the first period, folks. 58 points for Carolina, 52 points for Montreal. That time, that just flew by. That was a really exciting half. So we'll, the clock right now is saying just about 9.5 minutes. So we'll see you guys back here with about a couple minutes before the start of the second half. Our score, Carolina Roar Girls 58, Montreal News Kids on the block 52 right now. So that is an unbelievable halftime score. 6 points separating these two teams. And we were just talking, Brawl. I'm joined here by, I'm Kevin Up from Boston Derby Dames, in case you're wondering, one of the announcers there. Joined by Brawl McCartney from Queen City, Buffalo, right?
And a shout out to the viewing party on Traymore Street. Don't forget to feed the rabbits.
That's right. And a shout out to Bryant Mumble, announcer from Chicago. We know he's joining us on from his home. And my mom, of course. Hi, Mom.
This is up.
Anyways, we've got Roller Derby. So we've got, other than this big, there was one big power jam in the first half, in case you're just joining us. So Carolina, Holly Wanacrackia had a 19-0 power jam, and that is a Montreal. Other than that, has basically outplayed Carolina a little bit. It's inching those points away from Carolina and coming closer. So now they're within 6 points, and it's really going to be interesting to see if Carolina can hold off the Montreal Storm. Okay, so we are off here at the second period. And to start, we've got a, looks like a 3-3 pack out there, and Holly Wanacrackia.
Cheese crater and bone machine taking out Holly Wanacrackia in turn two there.
That's right. Offense, defense being played by Montreal at the front, Carolina playing defense in the back. Now it's sort of been mixed up a little bit. Georgia W. Tush is getting out for Montreal, but Holly Wanacrackia is the lead jammer for Carolina. Oh, we've got a little jammer-on-jammer action going on right now, as Holly Wanacrackia is trying to slow down Georgia W. Tush with a little extracurricular activities going on there. I think Holly Wanacrackia here, maybe he was looking for some sort of a hole to open up, and she does. She flies through the pack for 4 points, not calling off the jam, though. But now she's got some separation between her and Georgia W. Tush, so she's going to go here for a second scoring pass. And Holly Wanacrackia sneaking around the outside here. Well, she takes a seat. She calls off the jam. So no more points for either team on that pass. So an even jam, I believe. Or just about an even jam there. Okay, so we now have a 7-point lead for Carolina. So extending the lead by 1 point.
Yes. It did look like it was a scoreless jam, but
that score was passed there, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So, well, nonetheless, the score stands 55-62.
And it's 48 degrees.
Yes, it is. Okay, we've got Lil Mama trying to push her way through for Montreal, and she's got a path on the inside, passing Miss Anthrop the Mordant, and she is through as your lead jammer. And you can't see it on your screen there, but we've got a Carolina jammer out as well.
Montreal slowing it down for Lil Mama. She jumped the apex. Lil Mama. Oh, and she's down. And
Lil Mama, no. She looks like she has actually been sent to the penalty box. So even though she tried to call off the jam, she's been sent to for a major. So she initiated a hit with both skates off the ground there.
So that is actually
a misconduct. So she has been sent to the penalty box there. There is a major penalty. So this is actually power jam for Carolina.
Chasing Amy had to let her go there. They're sitting still on the track over by turn three.
Then Thrashley through again for a 5-point pass here. Carolina capitalizing on power jam once again.
Oh. Low block called number 17.
That's right, Miss Anthrop the Mordant.
Oh, she's still on the track to be a minor. Right.
And she's giving a little push there to her. Oh, we've got no pass, no penalty there. Is that a call? Oh, we actually have a 5-point pass there for Carolina's Thrashley.
There we go. Miss Anthrop finally being sent off to the box for Carolina. I saw that call.
That's right. So currently, for the moment, we've got one Carolina blocker. Now we're going to shortly have three Carolina blockers. And we've got also Lil Mama out of the box. She's through. That was actually a scoring pass for her. So she was able to pick up 5 points or 4 points in that scoring pass. Okay, and so the score right now, Carolina 82, Montreal to 59.
There's the Rev talking it over with the officials, looking very dapper, matching, wearing his team uniform colors.
Yes, he is.
Very French.
The team uniform pants, that's the most important part.
Yes.
About it.
Oh, he's back out.
All right, we've got official timeout called right now. And so we'll take this opportunity to tell you about ProTech Dent Mouth Guards, the sponsor of the WFTDA Championships. ProTech Dent Mouth Guards, the first thoroughly scientific mouth guard for the Derby player. Science protects their mouths now.
There's Heavy D talking to Conan the Vegetarian, one of the refs.
I also want to tell you about Ice Courts, another sponsor here. And take your league to the next level with Skate Court Roller Derby Flat Tracks. That would be Ice Courts. Thank you for sponsoring.
It's Heavy D in the red talking to Carolina. He's the coach of the Carolina Roller Girls All-Stars.
All right, we'll give you an update in a moment as what was being discussed. All right, Montreal wanted to review the misconduct call that was called on their jammer, and nothing has changed. The misconduct stands. Oh, nice block there by Nameless Horror, keeping Holly Wanna Crack Ya out in the pack, I should say. And we've got a major track cut on Holly Wanna Crack Ya. So now we've got, the roles have been reversed. This is a power jam. Is that Iron Wench out
Iron
there?
Iron Wench, number 516 for Montreal.
We've got a 3-3 pack right now for Iron Wench to work on. That was a nice block at the back by JoJo Gadget, but Iron Wench is still up. Little inside-outside move there, and that was a 5-point grand slam for Montreal. It's exactly what they needed to close that gap.
Oh, look at Montreal closing, trying to shut down JoJo Gadget in the back of the pack.
Yeah, but to no avail. JoJo Gadget just moving right by the Montreal, not able to put on the brakes fast enough.
Nameless Whore making a name for herself in this bout. She was able to clear a track for her jammer.
Wow, there was a big impact there with looks like Smack Daddy and JoJo Gadget. Smack Daddy being called off on a major. And that was a 5-point pass there for Iron Wench. And Montreal is closing this gap in a hurry. She's coming through on another scoring pass. Oh my gosh, she had three blockers to beat. Only one of her own on the track. They just didn't get their act together quite in time.
It's like she was able to hide behind Chasing Amy and scooted around on the outside lane there.
All right, Iron Wench coming through on another scoring pass. Holly Wanna Crack It here coming out. I believe this is Holly Wanna Crack It's first pass. What was that laugh about?
It was JoJo Gadget going down on the turn three of the hit and a miss. Swing and a miss.
We had a major track cut at the last second there on El Camino, the blocker from Carolina. And that was another 5-point pass for Montreal. If my math is correct, that was a 20-0 jam for Montreal. We have a 3-point game, everybody.
Woo-hoo. Iron Wench giving some high fives from her Montreal teammates.
That was definitely the biggest jam of the bout so far for Montreal. And that was, I think, maybe their first power jam as well.
Manjama Cool, number 1X, and number 2, Lil Mama back out there lining up for as a blocker. His blockers for Montreal.
That's right. I see Jesse King out there, number 110 for Carolina. And also DVS as well. And Carolina has had somebody else join them now that the jam has started. And there's a Montreal blocker also up who will be coming to join. So we're going to have a 3-3 pack in a matter of minutes. It's a matter of seconds. And the jam is finally off. The jammers are finally off. Holly Wanna Crack Ya here. Oh, we've got a full pack now for Montreal all of a sudden. Nonetheless, Georgia W. Tush is stuck at the back. We've got no lead jammer, though, due to a no pass, no penalty from Holly Wanna Crack Ya. That means she passed somebody while she was out of bounds and they were out of bounds. But regardless, Holly Wanna Crack Ya is on her scoring pass. She's at the front of the pack here. Georgia W. tushes through as your lead jammer. If she's smart, she's not going to call it out. That's right, she's not going to call it off. She's going to try and get those 4 points to even things up with Holly Wanacracker here.
Little Mama with a hit on the turn four there on the outside line on the Holly Wanacracker.
Oh, wow, but Holly Wanacracker is through here and finally and getting her 4 points. So Georgia W. Tush is going to try and pick up her four and most likely call off the jam here if she can get through. We shall see. She's got to get some of those points, though, first.
Devious trying to soften up the Montreal defense at the front of the pack.
So, well, she was able to pick up three, so minimizing the damage there. Not quite all four, so that was a positive 1 point jam there for Carolina.
Probably want to crack it, shining through on that last jam.
Yeah, that's right. She was not able to pick up lead jammer status, yet she was able to get the extra point.
Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solution, is a sponsor of WFTVABA.
That's right. We've got Ginger Clobbers now quickly through as the lead jammer for Carolina. That was before they'd even passed turn two. She was through. And Ginger Clobbers taking a knee as she goes across the inside of the track. Oh, she's got her hands up like she's going to call it off. She calls off the jam. Let's see if any points are picked up by Montreal. 3 points there. So Carolina with a costly late call off there. So they were still able to get 1 point, though.
It looked like she was trying to get eye contact with the ref as she was trying to time it. She'd want to just keep flapping her arms up there if the ref didn't see it. So that, like you said, it probably cost a second or two.
Yep. And that's all it took. All right, we're going to have a 3-2 pack advantage here for Carolina, so they're going to take a knee to get this jam started right away. Actually, in a matter of moments, they're going to have a 4-2 pack advantage as Jesse King, one of their blockers, is coming right off the penalty box. We've got a 4-2 advantage here for Carolina. Let's see if they can capitalize on it. They've got a wall at the back. They've got a no-pack situation, though, so they were out of play at the back. But then I guess we've got a lead jammer status, though, for Carolina. That was interesting, though. We actually had a situation where the people at the back of the pack were out of play, as was everybody at the front, so nobody was allowed to touch anybody. 3 points there for number 23, Aris Discordia, the jammer for Carolina.
She went up against Smack Daddy, who's been laying down some heavy hits for Montreal. I think this is going to be one of those games where there's a lot of hard hitting. We haven't seen a ton of hard hitting in a lot of the bouts that we saw yesterday. But I think this one, you're going to see a lot of exhausted players at the end. And I think this is where you're going to see a lot of people doing, trying to make some hard hits. We saw Carolina come out swinging, with particularly with 313, just JoJo Gadget.
That's right. She's bringing the boom. Okay, Jessie King, look at that. She loves skating backwards here to block. And we've got Devious. That might be Devious's first jam as a jammer today. Yeah. And she's quickly through as lead jammer. Georgia W. Tush trying to work her way past number 12, MC Fight at the front there, and she gets through. That was her first pass, so Carolina is scoring points here. And calling off the jam, Devious, and she gets a roar from the crowd. Anytime you see somebody who's typically a blocker who is actually out there jamming, that really, really inspires the crowd. And we've got a timeout call by Montreal, who just a few seconds ago was within 3 points, and all of a sudden we've got a 14-point lead for Carolina.
That was a sweet play right off the line, as you saw the defense for Montreal sort of tap, you know, slide across to the inside line. I don't know what they did to sort of distract them, to pull them over to that side, like a fake out or a juke or something, and then she squeaked through on the outside.
And folks, I want to tell you about Adam Wheels. Adam Wheels is the official wheel of the WFTDA. Be sure to check them out. That's Adam Wheels. Also, I want to tell you about 5 on 5 magazine, the official magazine of the WFTDA, 5on5.com.
I love that magazine.
You know what else I love? Sorry to interrupt you, but I really love shiny heinies and derby skins.
Oh, yeah.
Loves making your heinie shiny. So, folks, if you want to make me happy, shop at Derby Skins so I can see your shiny hiney.
If I had a hiney, I would have a shiny hiney.
How do you not have a hiney?
I don't work out. No idea.
Oh, does a hiney have to be like a big one? To be classified as a hiney?
Maybe it would make it look bigger if I wore it.
All right. Looks like our timeout in Montreal is over and we are back underway. We've got the Iron Wench out there jamming for Montreal. And she's through as your lead jammer.
Montreal keeping tabs on the front of the line there, building up a nice green wall.
Yes,
with Revolver number 38. Oh. Iron Wench being sent to the box.
That's right. We'll let you know if we see what figure out what that call was. It was actually while she was not in the pack. Maybe they might have figured out. No, that was she was sent off for a major. So she committed a major penalty outside of the pack there. So this is a power jam for Carolina. And Holly Wanakraka.
Oh, she's getting a lot of trouble from Smack Daddy up there at the front of the, who has to let her go finally, to the front of the pack. They slow down the pace. So that Holly Wanakraka is going to catch up.
That's right. And that was looked like her first scoring pass there. So Holly Wanakraka here on her second one. But we've got that again, that green wall there at the front. Smack Daddy, once again, that's going to be a major low block on her, taking out Holly Wanakraka. She sort of took out Holly's legs.
Carolina trapping number 38, Revolver, at the back of the pack, controlling the pace.
And Holly there passing through at the front, the Montreal wall. And that is a four-point pass. For Carolina, who's
Carolina
opening
has,
up a lead.
They've got a goat back there.
That's right, they do. Ray Volver really going to need to do some work to get out of this, and that's probably smart on her part just to push into the backs there. Sometimes it makes more sense to commit a back block penalty and get out of it.
JoJo Gadget trying to get a hit on Iron Wench.
So Iron Wench, though, that was a scoring pass for Iron Wench, so she is out. She scored 4 points. We have no lead jammer. That was a five-point pass for Holly Wanakraka. So we still have 3 seconds left. Let's see if she can get back in. Iron Wench, don't think she got in there at the end. No, she didn't. 3 more points, though, for Carolina. So Iron Wench desperately trying to get in some points there at the end there, but to no avail.
That defense from Carolina was just brutal. Just all over number 38 from Montreal. They would not let her get through, and Revolver just looking frustrated, but just powering on, trying to get through there. It looks like there's a timeout as some of the coaches are out there talking to the officials.
That's right. It looks like it's an official timeout right now. And, you know, that's where I sort of have mixed feelings. If I were a coach, I'm sometimes tempted to tell my goat, that's what we call the person who gets trapped at the back there. Sometimes I'm tempted to tell them, just start clawing your way through everybody. Use your hands. Get to the front. It's not the most ethically sound thing to do, it's going to get your team out of a whole boatload of trouble. You just got to get out of the back somehow.
Take the penalty.
Yep.
Most likely it'll be a minor.
That's right. Or you know what? Even if it's a major, then, hey, they send you off, and, hey, look at that. There's no more goat. Just like that.
You can get all Jim Parcells on everyone.
Play the penalties. Well, we want to tell you about another sponsor for the WFTDA Championships. That would be Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates is ready to fix your gear. Be sure to look them up. Sin City Skates.
You know why these girls are so fast? Probably because they use Fast Girl Skates. They're a pioneer in boot sizing and configuration for women's feet, including the split last and narrow skates, and they're all in stock and ready to ship to you. Fast Girl Skates. Not Slow Girl, Fast Girl Skates.
Yes.
You see Carolina and Montreal trying to wait out this timeout.
Well, I'll also tell you about Green Monster Roller Sports, a.k.a. Heartless. Green Monster Roller Sports selling antique boots, reckless wheels, and moto bearings. Revolutionizing roller derby, Green Monster Roller Sports.
Cheese grater out there with a pivot helmet, pivot stripe on. She used to be a jammer for Montreal back in the day.
That's right. Now she's one of their most effective blockers on the team. Mm-hmm. Definitely one of, we've seen some big hits from her today as well.
You see a lot of jammers shift to the blocker position, and they're just excellent blockers. They know how to slice through the pack and just have that laser precision when they find their victim.
Absolutely. Look at that. They're doing a little dance right now. That's Conan showing some, probably not showing some dance moves, but it sure looks like to the A managers from both teams. A lot of nodding, a lot of beards.
A lot of beards. A lot of fashion. A lot of fashion sense on the coaches.
That's right. I don't know which one's better dressed.
I got to go with the Rev.
Probably a good decision.
And he wins hands down. Pelvis is shaking his head. Yes on Rev. I think that's a requirement to be a reverend. You have to be a great dresser. Team's getting ready. Look at Carolina trying to face down, starting backwards. Cheese grater and revolver up against number 8 for Carolina. She does not get lead jam. She gets sent to the box for a back blocking call.
Oh, she calls off the jam. All right. Interesting decision by Georgia W. Tush. The call off the jam there. They had a power jam. They had lead jammer status and immediately called it off. And she is kicking herself right now. She knows that was a mistake. However, we've been filled in. We were trying to figure out what that call was a couple jams ago on the Iron Wench when she was outside of the pack. Mm-hmm. She actually, so Holly Wanakrakia, the jammer for Carolina, had actually lost her panty on the track, or lost the jammer star on the track. And Iron Wench actually knocked it off of the track. And that was considered insubordination, and so she was given a call for that. Or misconduct, pardon me. All right, but anyways, we are back. So Montreal has a power jam. They've got Iron Wench out there. And Jessie King was giving her a hard time. And she's got to let her go. We've got a strong lead jammer status earned by Iron Wench. Looks like MC Fight was also up there. So we've got a 4-4 sort of split in the pack here. Montreal happy to dilly-dally here. But they've got to get in there and play a little offense to make their way for Iron Wench.
Smack Daddy scooted up there to try to break up the Carolina wall. She's got one more to pass.
Looks like MC Fight once more at the front. So that was a 4-point pass. Due to a no pass, no penalty. There she passed somebody while she was out of bounds, and they were out of bounds.
Pack slowing down.
Here comes Iron Wench on another scoring pass here. And we've got a Carolina jammer out of the penalty box. And that's number 8, Deviled Legs. She is quickly through in her first scoring pass. That's going to limit the damage here.
I think people are getting a little tired and losing a little pack awareness. As she scooted through, nobody saw her as they were all concentrating on Iron Wench.
That's right. And Iron Wench really had to call it off there. So it looks like she was able to pick up 3 more points, so a total of 7 points in that jam for Montreal. Although I'm guessing, you know, they're probably still kicking themselves because Georgia W. Tush, right when they got that power jam, during the last jam, she just called it off right when she got through. When she got lead jammer, you know.
Oh, yeah.
But nonetheless, they're still within striking distance. We've got about half a period left to go. 121 points for Carolina, 96 points for Montreal. Montreal, pardon me.
Carolina, or I think they're going to keep that point that they took away last year, and then some.
Yes, they are. All right, we got a no-pack situation, and jammers are off.
Georgia W. Tush being held up in the back.
Oh, and Holly Wanakrakia called out. Looks like a major block in the back.
Low block.
Looks like major block in the back was on Holly Wanakrakia. The major low block was on Bone Machine, the blocker from Montreal, who fell down and then sort of tripped somebody behind her. So it's interesting how both of those were called at the same time.
Georgia trying to find her way through that wall of black from Carolina. Cheese grater trying to slow things down in the back. Carolina sneaking up on Georgia.
All right.
But they had to let her go as they had a split pack situation.
And a 5-point grand slam for Montreal, who has now passed into the 100s. They're within 20 points here, and their power jam still remains, and we've got a really slow pack. Good opportunity for Georgia W. Tush. Oh, and she gets through. Surprised there was not a out-of-play penalty called on Miss Anthrop the Mordant there. She's going back to the penalty box. She just can't decide where she wants to be right now. We've got a really slow pack right now and a slight pack advantage for Montreal. Georgia W. Tush trying to get through here. What would be, I believe, her 3rd scoring pass. Jessie King, though, we've seen some amazing one-on-one blocking for Jessie King. Backwards skating there and facing Georgia W. Tush. And Tush is through with a 4-point pass.
Yeah, pink slip in number 224 and Jessie King out there for Carolina doing some excellent blocking.
Yeah, I've been really impressed today with Jessie King specifically. I didn't know too much about Carolina. I didn't know too much about Jessie King, but she has really incredible skating skills and a lot of backwards blocking. She likes to face the people coming towards her. it must be intimidating to skating up on another blocker and just having her staring you down, you know?
Yeah, there's just something you just don't want to skate. I don't know what it is. It's like a natural thing. You just don't want to attack something face on while it's looking at you.
Yep. All right, this is a timeout call for Carolina here. So we're going to tell you about one more, another sponsor here. Five Stride Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop of Bonnie Thunders, Deranged, Psychobabble, Susie Hartrod, and Teflon Donna. Again, that's the Five Stride Skate Shop.
It's an 11-point game. Montreal 110, Carolina 121.
This is incredibly close, obviously. This goes without saying, but I think this one's going to come down to just the last minute or two here. We're going to be seeing some exciting stuff down to the end. All these early birds here who came out to see this bout are just going to see a great ending.
Here we go. Birthday cake formation.
For Montreal, looks like they have a 4-2 pack advantage here. So they want to get this jam started immediately.
Stealing some lines from Suzanne Wins.
Oh, it's actually a 4-2 advantage, and taking full advantage of it, Lil Mama, captain for Montreal.
Celia Fate's got a wall of green to get through.
Wow, she just turned on the burners there, though, and blew by them. So that's going to limit the damage here. But Lil Mama going to try and get probably a quick scoring pass in here, see what she can do. Celia Fate is bearing down. Lil Mama's skate might have gone out of bounds there, and she did get a track cut at the back. And now Celia Fate's actually passed her. Oh, and Lil Mama, major track cut. Fourth minor, so minor track cut. She earned her fourth minor. So a power jam for Carolina. Very costly decision here, putting in Lil Mama, who may have had three minors starting that jam. And that was a 5-point scoring pass for Celia Fate right here.
DVS and Misanthrope trying to keep the head of the pack clear for their jammer as they're up against Tilou. It looks like Nameless Horror stepped.
That's right. That was five more points there, and that scoring pass for Celia Fate. Amazing. Another 5-point scoring pass for Celia Fate. This jam, totally different right now. It started off 4-2 advantage for Montreal. Lil Mama had lead jammer, and now we've got Celia Fate getting her third Grand Slam in a row. And there's still 30 seconds left in this jam. Oh, here we go. So Celia Fate now finally slowed down a little bit. There was a no-pack situation there, but there's two blockers for Montreal on the pack, in the pack. And they are actually doing a pretty good job slowing down Celia Fate right now. They've got to really slow down, turn on the brakes, and they have done so.
Smack Daddy finally took down Celia Fate.
That's right. And time's going to expire here, looks like, before Lil Mama can get back. And that was four more points for Carolina. Weren't you just saying that it was an 11-point game?
It was. Carolina turned up the heat as they just played as a unit out there. It looks like they're putting out it's like the heavier blockers against the heavier blockers out as they try to clear pass for their quickly diminishing jammers. I think this is gonna be an exhausting game. It's but Carolina, I think when we go back to the beginning of the jam with the backward start, I think they're starting to get into Montreal's head a little bit. As they start to dominate these jams a little more outright.
Oh, wow. A costly mistake there. Deviled legs, a major track cut. An iron wench out there for Montreal. And she has got to come in behind JoJo Gadget, who just stopped there and made iron wench waste about 10, 15 seconds figuring out where she should come back into the pack. And she is finally through as a lead jammer here, although that time on that penalty has ticked off quite a bit.
Yeah, she was waiting for that. Looks like Carolina set up a trap, then they closed it shut on Iron Wench, but she got through.
Oh, and Iron Wench keeping one skater, left skate inbounds there, snuck around the outside for a 5-point grand slam. Unbelievable skating right there.
Iron Wench, she's an exciting skater to watch.
That's right, here she comes up on the back again. Oh, nice JoJo Gadget just sticking her booty in her face, knocking her out. Unbelievable. But JoJo Gadget did get a direction of play penalty there, it looks like. And Iron Wench is through for a 5-point grand slam. back and forth this bout goes. Unbelievable. Although Carolina has been in the lead almost the entire bout, Montreal is in striking distance.
Deviled Legs back on the track.
That's right. This is Deviled Legs' first scoring. That was her first pass, though. She did not get any points, so Iron Wench has a little bit more time to try and get some more points. And she has emerged on her next, her third scoring pass here. Calls off the jam. 4 points there. So a huge jam for Montreal. Right back at you.
They're using the entire track. I don't think there's any, there's no one advantage. Like, usually you see a team that's like masters the inside or the outside, but at these championships, you're going to see everybody just, you have to know, you have to be able to master the entire track back and forth.
You absolutely do. These skaters, their lateral movement on the track is really improving every year, especially with these two teams. And so being able to go from the outside to the inside, back and forth, it's not a big deal anymore.
Carolina, the way they shut that back door and that last jam was amazing. It looked like it was pretty clear, but then all of a sudden they just kind of came into formation, blocking Iron Wench for a moment.
That's right, but Iron Wench pulled off a 14-0 jam there.
What a slow start on this jam.
That's right. So we've got a no-pack, so finally we can get our jammers off. And that little mama around the outside, accelerating on the turns, getting lead jammer for Montreal.
Oh. Probably want to crack. You finally got through on the outside.
That's right. The pack was slow enough that Lil Mama, usually passing on the outside on the turns is very challenging, but Lil Mama, no problem there. It's a slow pack. Oh, she sneaks on through. Let's see if she knows to call it off. Not calling off the jam, though. She's hoping that her blockers are going to maybe hold Holly Want to Crack It. I'm not sure the decision there. So let's see. She was able to. Ah, see, it was 4-4 there. So Lil Mama costing her team 4 points right there. Very odd decision there. I'm just sort of shaking my head right here. Don't really get that decision right there. Once she had decided to allow Holly Want to Crack It back in, she really probably should have kept going around and tried to make another pass, but that's where we are. 19-point lead for Carolina. No difference.
I'd like to remind you that Wicked Skatewear is one of our sponsors, Wicked Skatewear, and they're also...
Oh, pardon to interrupt, but did you see that? Ginger Clobbers just hopping across on the inside, and she is the lead jammer. We'll tell you a little bit more about Wicked Skatemare in a little bit.
Iron Wench working her way past the Carolina defender, number 12, MC Fight.
Oh, Ginger Clobber owning the inside here. Oh, do we have a major track cut, though? Another jammer penalty. She was on her scoring pass. She might have picked up a few points before she hit the box there, but... Iron Wench, another power jam. Neither team.
Carolina shutting the door on Iron Wench. They push her out the window on turn three.
Unbelievable. Each time one team makes a run, the other team's making a run right back at them. Oh, we've got a major track cut now on Iron Wench. So our jammers are going to tag up. Iron Wench is going to come on out.
Ginger Clobbers back
in. Not Iron Wench, pardon me. Ginger Clobbers will. And Iron Wench will sit in the box for as long as... Ginger Clobbers sat in the penalty box.
Ginger Clobbers getting through that line from Montreal.
That was a scoring pass there for Ginger Clobbers. 5 points. So both jammers on scoring passes now. Both of them out of the penalty box. We're going to go the full 2 minutes. We got over about 40 seconds left in the jam.
Montreal figured out how to open that door in the back that Carolina keeps closing and letting Myron Wench through. Probably want to crack it, getting some trouble from him at Georgia W. Tush.
Yeah, Georgia W. Tush also bringing out the backwards block there. And Iron Wench trying to get through in her scoring pass, and she does. And that was a four-point pass as they're both on the same lap, so there's no lap point there. Ginger Clobber, though, also on the same scoring pass, although it looks like Iron Wench may have a chance to lap her here. Oh, but Iron Wench taken out a very key moment there and was able, no additional points on that scoring pass. That was huge. I think we might have been a wash, just about a wash in that jam for both teams. And folks, I want to tell you about one more of our sponsors, another drink sponsor here, Honest Tea. Honest Tea donated drinks for all of our volunteers here, and it is delicious. Honest Tea. Check them out. So we have almost 4 minutes to go here. We've got a 20-point lead for Carolina, Montreal.
Lil Mama up against the Carolina Jammers as she's turning around. She's trying to get past turn three, and she beats them through the middle.
And she got lead jammer status. Holly Wanacrack is stuck at the back of the pack. So Montreal, needing to make a run, does have lead jammer status and a stuck jammer from Carolina. Here comes Little Mama up on the rear of the pack. She's looking for a hole to get through. Carolina does not know she's there. And she has gotten through in her first pass. And she calls off the jam. She's not going to bother wasting time right now trying to get that lap point. Only 3 minutes left. 1 point is not what they need. They need a lot more than that. Wasn't worth the time.
You live and learn as a jammer.
Flying Dog Brewery is a sponsor of the WFTDA Championships. Flying Dog, the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs. Flying Dog Brewery.
I recommend the Pale Ale.
And I want to tell you also about Merch Mama, who's supplying swag to the Derby Nation. MerchMama.com. That's MAMA.com. All right, and we are off here. And we've got a major block in the back. I can't believe on Thrashley, it didn't look like that much contact, but it was enough to knock her out of the way, and she was the last blocker, so it made it a major.
Great jam, number 40, Georgia Tush. She waved down in turn two, but she caught up to the pack, and she's getting her way through.
Wow, and she is through. That was a five-point pass. So keep your eye on that score. We've got an 11-point game with 2 minutes to go right now. Georgia W. Tush on a power jam. She sneaks right through. Five more points. 6 point bout. She needs two more passes. Quick, another one. 5 point pass. They're within 1 point right now. The power jam still going on here for Montreal. They've got a slow pack. She's passed. Unbelievable. The pack hasn't even moved. Another 5 points for Georgia W. Tush. Can you believe it? The first lead of the game, and we are a minute and a half to go. Another five-point pass for Georgia W. Tush. This is unbelievable, folks. One of the best power jams I've ever seen right now. The pack has not even budged. All she has to do is really avoid penalties right here. And Carolina finally moving the pack back to try and force a penalty. No points scored on that final pass, but we've got a 9-point lead for Montreal with 1 minute to go. I can't believe what we just saw.
People are on their feet cheering for Montreal.
I'm absolutely freaking out. You know what? This is unbelievable. This reminds me of what it's like to be a warrior, folks. And if you are a warrior, make sure you check out warrior-.com and check that out. Prove to everybody that you are also a warrior. Maybe while you're at it, read Blood and Thunder magazine.
Looks like we have 1 minute.
1 minute on the dot. Isn't that convenient? A very convenient amount of time.
Wow.
Oh, the crowd here is getting worked up into a frenzy right now. Very few people are sitting down. Those that are sitting down wish they were standing up.
I don't think I need any more coffee today. This has been amazing.
All right. So, as you can see, folks, they're lining up for this what is most likely going to be the last jam. And now, of course, we have an official timeout being called. Before the very last jam of an incredibly tight bout, they want to make sure they've got everything right. So I think Montreal, what would you say the most important thing for Montreal to make sure they do is during this bout?
No penalties. They don't want to get any penalties. No majors.
Yeah, it seems, I would say that if Montreal can keep, with a 9-point lead, as long as they can keep their jammer on the track, they can just get her out even once.
Yeah.
They should be all set. But that's sometimes easier said than done. We've seen, I don't know the official numbers on it, but an incredible amount of power jams. Really, that's in the name of the game, is capitalizing on power jams. What was that, like a 25-point power jam there,
like
that?
Yeah. Well, you got to figure, the teams have been so even, and Montreal was sort of, as you were talking about before, Montreal seemed to be outplaying Carolina, but Carolina was always up because of that 19-point power jam they had in the first period, and now it's a power jam to Montreal. Look what's happened. We're up, they're leading.
Boston Massacre is standing behind us here for Montreal. They love their Montreal. New Skids on the Block here. It looks like, I think that's Iron Wench out there. Against Devious, actually. It's actually Devious,
yes,
for Carolina. And so we have it started off already, so they took a knee. Iron Wench is your lead jammer. if she can run the clock down and avoid getting a penalty right here, looks like Montreal's got it. If I were her GM coach, I would tell her not to engage with the pack. Don't even risk it. But she is going to go for it. She's risking getting a penalty here. Doesn't matter. She's gotten the points.
She had enough room to get through.
That's pretty much going to be it there, as long as she doesn't get called out for a penalty. That was 4 points for her. It looks like Devious is actually stuck. And Devious has finally emerged from the pack as well. Now she's emerged for 4 points. Iron Wench is going back in. This is a really risky maneuver here for Iron Wench. I don't see any reason why she's engaging with the pack, but she is choosing to do so. She wants more points, and she's got them. 5 seconds left in the period. Let's see if she calls it off. And she lets a few extra seconds go off, and Montreal with a comeback for the ages. Bro McCartney, I can't believe we just saw that. Montreal losing the entire bout, coming back with just 1 minute to go with like a 25-point power jam and emerging as 13-point victors unofficially over Carolina.
You never write off Montreal. They've been the surprise team. They've been the spoiler. Not so much the spoiler, because I think people know enough and respect Montreal that they know that they've always gone down. There's been a lot of bouts where they've been behind, and they've come from behind and won.
Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed watching this bout with the Montreal New Skids on the block. There they go, right past your camera, the victors against the Carolina All-Stars.
Beautiful, beautiful defense played by Carolina at the whole bout, through the whole bout.
That was absolutely one for the ages, folks. So hopefully you enjoyed that. And stay tuned. In about 9 minutes, 9 to 10 minutes or so, we are going to be bringing out at you the unofficially named Lobster Palooza. It's unofficial. WFTDA is not giving me a thumbs up to call it that. But it has been Boston versus Maine. That's coming up in just about 10 minutes. If you enjoyed this one, you are going to see some more great derby for the rest of the day, I am sure. So, Ron McCartney, it was great calling with you.
Same.
I am Kevin Up, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye-bye.